3D printers, and suddenly you have to change the law about weapons, because everyone can just print it out and have a pistol at home if you have a 3D printer. And that's a new reality, and I guess the biggest amount of states not yet even know what to do with it. So but that's just one little idea before we move on to IT. Where's our IT expert? Please welcome. And he is Head of Department of Quality and Development at Agency 77, Carlo Becchi. And he's worldwide specialist.
Hello. How many Twitter accounts in the room? Raise your hand if you have a Twitter account.
Please. Twitter account.
Twitter account. Take this, Al Gore. So I will say hello to you first on Twitter and then in real life. My handle is Carlo Becchi. But for those of you, the few of you that know what is a convenient room but don't know what is Twitter, I will tell you that my name is Carlo Becchi, coming from Italy. It's 3 years that I live in Latvia, anyway. I'm the head of development of 77 Agency. We are a marketing agency. Here in Latvia, we produce technology for marketing. We have quite a big research and development center. I will challenge you immediately before going to the future with taking a look back to the past. Not so far, but can you tell me who this man is? Any idea? None of you? Okay, I will make it easier.
Oh yeah.
Any idea? No? Yeah? Okay. The device is called One Laptop Per Child, and this gentleman is Nicolas Negroponte, and he has quite a lot of achievement in his life. He's the founder of MIT Media Lab. He's the first investor of Wired magazine. And in 1995, he wrote a book called Being Digital. He predicted new touch interface, but that's easy, everybody does that. And since we talk about media, he mentioned his switch. So he said that we assign for a series of engineering mistake, he called, the wrong channel to the wrong media. For example, telephone, that are the most personal device we can think now, is born like a cable device, while television, that is one to many, was free to air, over the air. And the switch comes when positions are taken naturally because of scarcity of resources. The electromagnetic bandwidth is much shorter, it's very precious. So now, the personal devices are going over the air, while we need more bandwidth for the static media, like TV that is going through cable or through the internet that is mostly delivered by cable. But he states that we should stop thinking about moving atoms. The object, the physical objects are gone. Music is not the CD, it's the music. Movie is not the DVD or the VHS, or what it was called, cassette. It's the movie itself. This is in 1995, that is 8 years before iTunes Music Store opened. It's pretty impressive. And let's see what is lying ahead, because now we are entering another world, that is the social world. Social world means social network, means Twitter, means Drawing, means Facebook, of course. This generates aberration in mankind, in my opinion. So, from one side, there is people that is very, very, very concerned about privacy and security. These are social issues, I think. The problems that we face now are problems that were not present 10 years ago, doing something and leaving tracks somewhere. Something that is not good in some way, or information we were not supposed to share. Probably everybody of us, when he's hiring, I'm talking for people in the industry, is checking LinkedIn before when they receive a CV. And the other phase of the aberration is people like me, for example, that was Twittering all the time, that is on Foursquare, and leaving precise track of where I am or at a specific moment. And this is Waze, for example, it is very used in Latvia. So this is the position, a snapshot of the position of the people who yesterday when I took this my car, of course, which is a navigator social network that is geolocalized. And that was the traffic situation yesterday at 11:30 in Riga. As you know, 2 weeks ago we had a beautiful marathon that I suggest you to attend. I ran, and of course I was with my phone and Endomondo, that is another social network for sports. And you can see, if you go in this page, you can follow my half marathon, moment by moment, knowing the speed of every time. But you can even check what I was listening as music, because he kept track. I don't know exactly why, because it's not an option, but he knows what I was listening every moment. This is the hyper-connected world. There were people standing at home that were sending messages through Endomondo, and a synthesized voice was reading these messages while I was running. That was quite a cool experience. And there are other ways to interact with this world that is already there, is the Internet of Things. So let's distribute information and processing power through objects. Let's put a tag, something on this stuff, I don't know the English word, that tells what it is. So object can interact. This is the most simple, and sadly it's so badly used by marketers. But it's a brilliant idea. It's just a QR code. As you can see, you can take a picture. There's my full business card in that. Who needs paper anymore? If you put this kind of text, the QR code, on object, a machine can understand, a telephone can understand what it is and have information about it. And since we develop technology and we like to play a lot with technology, we also develop this machine that is called a social machine. The basic concept is to associate any kind of social media, social network account to a physical object. This allow to bring the experience of social media into real life. I will try to demonstrate how it works, trying some kind of trick of magic. I touch with my hand and the machine, okay? The secret is that I have a RFID bracelet where it is associated to my Facebook account. And now you can see it, but there's my name. I'm behaving, the machine is doing action on my behalf on my Facebook account. This is just a demo, it's a photo booth, but I can take, for example, a picture. Please smile. Mm-hmm. Of this amazing audience. There's a nice logo of Riba University, and I can share on my Facebook account. That's it. This is just a photo booth. It's a very simple demo. It doesn't change the world. But think about being in a museum and having your bracelet and just swiping. You see Mona Lisa, you can take picture in Louvre. You just want to share with your friend that you were there and you want to share on Facebook a nice picture. Just swipe your bracelet on the painting itself, there's a small reader, and it will do on your behalf. Any action can be, it works even with the Foursquare. You can check in or do chain of action, taking a picture and tag it on the Foursquare. This is an example, interaction through the digital world and the physical world. And what we will see in the future that we are already seeing now is all these new media and all these new devices going towards one that at the moment is the phone. Maybe it will not be the phone in 10 years. But we can pay Google Wallet with the NFC technology. We can, in US, selected store, you can pay with your Google account, basically. You can use it as a loyal card, as an ID card. You can use it as a contact hub. Take a picture of my business card, it goes directly on your contact that probably is synchronized with your contacts on the PC. And all the area network, you use the Bluetooth headset that now is quite out of fashion, luckily, but you have the bracelet to track your sleep cycle. And of course, you have stuff like this, the terrible and the much discussed Google Glass. What is that? It's just another Android device that sits on your face and has a camera. This is I call it privacy nightmare on your nose, because people are already afraid of being filmed all the time. What it does? Well, technically, it should do what is called augmented reality. So we have reality, we put a layer of digital information on top of it. The back is just your eyesight. You are using navigator, and it's not really projected, but it's a small display that basically, if you look up, you can see it's like having a TV screen floating on your face. You can have this technology that is used in cars, used born, of course, for a jet fighter, I think, head-up display. And you can Google Translate stuff. So basically, you just ask, okay, glass, that is the keyword to start, say half a pound in Chinese, and you know that the translation is not like the one of Google Translate, but you know that is exactly Google Translate. So you hope that you are not insulting the whatever spinach seller in Chinese. How good it works? Well, this is Android. If you have an Android phone, we have already all these functions, so we know that it's not really that amazing. But still, it's fascinating. You can ask questions, of course, it just send messages to a server that collect back the information and select the, probably the stronger point is selecting the good ones. I don't know if you try Google now, it's telling me already how long it will take to go back to my home, because I search, I use the navigator to come here, and if I search anything, it said, well, it's 20 minutes because there's a little traffic in Valdemar. This is something that Google Glass is still for few people, mostly developer or media, but this is something you can try immediately. This is Ingress. Is an Android game, again, augmented reality, massive multiplayer game. This is not really on Vision, but you are in your town, this is Riga, for example. There's a layer on the map of Riga that tells a story about two factions working to control some kind of energy grid. So people have to go around town. It's quite a good exercise in comparison with static video games. And try to steal each other, form alliance with others to win over the other faction. Basically, it's just it's really embarrassing. I try to tell you. Basically, it's going with your headphone and pointing your phone and pressing it in the middle of old town. You can imagine the sensation. But if you see this log, I don't know, DH, DJ, etc., etc., linked yesterday at 12:42 p.m., the Defense Ministry in Valdemara with the monument to Oscar Kalpa, that is general First World War, that is closed. So basically, there's an entire war that is going on in some way without we realize. And this is a war that is in. In our town, it's a different level. It reminds me of Tron. Maybe you have seen at least the terrible sequel. And what we can think now, starting from Nicholas Negroponte, that said, let's stop thinking about atom. Let's think about bits. Now we are in the digital age. Movies are on digital format, we can download, we can stream it. Music is the same. Almost all the important goods we use today and information sources come to our phone, to our PC. Now it's time to bring back the atom, because technology is advancing, the technology of material mostly, and the mechanical engineer, that this coming back of this technology that is called 3D printing. The idea is, it existed since the 80s, it was called rapid prototypization, I think. It was used to make this Logitech design these remote controls. Said, okay, it's cool, it's nice on the computer-aided design. Let's see how it fits in the end. Create a mock-up, fake one, just piece of plastic, and you can try it. Yes, it's comfortable. Let's go in production. And you can do Rabbit now, for example, downloading the project from the internet and have your whole family of rabbits, even different color, I guess. Mm-hmm. But this one costs $1,500. It's very limited, of course. And okay, yeah, you can do dinosaurs and a spaceship. It's not really something that will change your world. When the first 3D printer appeared, I remember the media say stuff like, yes, the next iPhone will be downloaded and printed at home. Yes, if the next iPhone is a brick of plastic, this will be the case. If not, it's a little too soon. But also this technology that is just for hobbyists at the moment can lead a change. There is people that print with living tissue and is making a kidney or a bladder out of raw material. This is from a couple of days ago. They made a custom a plastic airway for a kid that has a malformation and was not able to breathe without tracheotomy. And perfect. They just measured. They just take the measure, put on a computer, and was precise to millimeter. And of course, well, space pizza. NASA is investing in a 3D printer for food to have balanced food created in the space station. And of course, as it was mentioned, gun. This is the Liberator. It's more provocative, I hope, tool than really a tool. But the idea is that how the laws needs to change, because my predecessors talk about copyright. We can envision, because there's people that are really scared about the idea of the pirated object. I mean, do you like my glass? I downloaded it yesterday from Pirate Bay and printed it with my 3D printer. This will be probably, well, not the future, this one, but the return back to another kind of interaction with the physical world that is around us. And if you have some question, Amir, if not, I'm done. Thank you.
So the questions, please. Oh, come on, you must have questions on this. All right, how many of you have seen 3D printer in presence in front of you? 3D printer, anyone? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, anybody else? 6, 7. So how far or how long it will take to have one at your home or in office?
1 year.
1 year? At your home? All right, you have a lot of money. Good. What will be the first thing you will print out? And not your home. Yeah. What will be the first thing you will print out?
I see 1 year ago.
What will you print out first? Money. Good. And your pistol. Gun, yeah, of course. All right, there we go. Global war, I guess. Any more questions, please, to Mr. Becky? No. Thank you. It's too clear from the beginning. Thank you.